I stopped dancing. I wasn't in the disco anymore. I was wearing glasses. I don't wear glasses. My eyes refocused, and for the first time, I could see where I was. I was on a stage in front of what? 1, 2, 3, 6 billion people. I tried to speak.
Hello.
But all that came out was this strange shape covered with colours. The mix of colours was giving me a headache, and I noticed that the bits could move around. I wondered what intricate mysteries God would reveal to me if I solved the puzzle. But every time I moved a bit, it just got more mixed up. Until I decided to throw the cube into the air. And when I caught it, it was somehow solved on all sides. I waited for God to reveal his intricate mysteries. But God just said,
"There is no cube. It's all in your head."
And when I looked back down at my hands, the cube just vanished. There was a cry from the crowd. Someone shouted out, "Show us a card trick, wanker."
"Show us a card trick, wanker."
This made me nervous, and my hands began to sweat. Sometimes I sweat a little. Sometimes I sweat a lot. Sometimes I sweat out a whole pack of cards and their box. As I looked around the crowd for someone to help me with my card trick, I realised that I couldn't see a thing.
Shit!
I do wear glasses. I couldn't remember where I had put them, though, so I had to improvise instead. I wandered over to a girl. "Follow me," I said.
"Follow me."
"Take a seat," I said.
"Take a seat."
"I'm pleased to meet you," I said.
"I'm pleased to meet you."
I lied. I explained to her.
"In this box there are 52 cards, and what I'm about to do is just swell."
I decided to speak like an American. People love Americans. They're such good listeners. I continued by whispering into her ear. What an idiot. I'd meant to say, "Name a card, any card." I'm rubbish at speaking to pretty girls. I always make them nervous. I think she understood what I meant, though, because she named a card anyway. I leaned in close so that I could hear her.
"Three of spades."
She'd said the three of spades.
"The queen of hearts it is, then."
I tried to change her mind. It didn't work. Nervously, I opened the box. And inside, I found something that surprised even me. There was only one card inside the case. And when I showed it to the audience, they began to make this noise with their hands, for it was the card she'd freely named, the Three of Spades. I looked smug, and I pretended that this coincidence was just a part of my act. The girl was so impressed that she wanted to give me a kiss on the lips. But she didn't. I wanted to take her hand, but it was attached firmly to the end of her arm. So I just used it to lead her back to her seat. I did this in the style of a homosexual. Women love what they can't have. As I walked back to the stage, I realized that I was wearing glasses.
I don't wear glasses.
"You
You're always there, shouting out my thoughts like a foghorn.
I said.
No, you're not there. You're in my head.
I said.
I know how to get rid of you. Dr. Burns gave me those pills. I've got them just here.
Are you looking for these?
You knew I'd try this. You stopped me last time. But if you're just in my head, you can't be holding those pills. I am.
Shit. I didn't take the pills.
I was silenced. I was paralyzed. Then the man covered me up with a sheet. Out of sight, out of mind. I was helpless. There was nothing I can do. I was forced to leave the man I was controlling alone, and I vanished from his life forever.
Don't do this.